All right, guys, I did it. This is an Android, the Google Pixel 3a. It's here in my hands. I've made the leap. I've shared with you how I'm abandoning Apple's ecosystem, moving into the Google ecosystem, and I made the biggest leap, my first Android phone. Let's talk about what it's been like to make the transition and if I think it's gonna last. All right, I'm in the middle of quarantine. I live here in New York City. And at the beginning of quarantine, I thought, you know what, this is gonna be a while. And I travel a lot. And I thought, if there's ever a good time to make the leap to an Android, it's when I'm trapped at home. And if I'm, you know, I can play with it, but I'm not really out there, out and about. And so if it doesn't work out, I'll be okay. So I went and I bought a Google Pixel 3a. I switched to Google Fi cell phone services. Away from AT&T, and I made the leap to a Pixel 3a, and it was about $300 for a new Android phone. But here's the reality: I've been an Apple fanboy for a decade plus. I waited in line for 15 hours for the iPhone 4. This is the first iPhone. This was my first iPhone, and it was the first iPhone. This is the 4 gigabytes. iPhone 4 gigabytes, and it's heavy, and isn't it cute? Look how little it is. But this was a game changer when this came out, and I was so proud of this iPhone. And my last iPhone, I paid over $1,000 for, and I thought it was worth it. And the truth is, it's still the amount I use a smartphone, and the amount you use a smartphone, it might be worth $1,000. But the reality is, when there is another phone that's out there that has similar specs, is it worth paying an extra $700 for a phone that can do just as much? Well, I decided to take the leap, and the truth is, I bought a cheaper Android device, a $300 Pixel 3a, which is a good device. It's kind of middle of the line when it comes to Androids. It's not top of the line, and it's not cheap, and I figured it's a Google, so it's probably gonna integrate Google stuff better than anything else, so it might be easier for me to use. And so I made the leap. I took the jump, and I am stepping away from Apple in the biggest way when it comes to my iPhone device. Now, here's a few things that I've learned along the way. The first thing that I've learned is it's much easier to make the leap to an Android device when you're already in the Google ecosystem. So I had moved my laptop away from a MacBook to a Chromebook, because I was already using a lot of the Google platforms. And so because I used Gmail and Google Calendar and Google Drive, it was very natural and easy for me to switch over to an Android device. So if you're an Outlook person, or if you're actually using, you're that person out there that's using Mac Mail or Apple, whatever the mail device is that's so bad, at least from my perspective, then it's going to be tough. Now, honestly, the Exchange app, because I actually do use Outlook for one of my email email addresses and calendars, the Exchange app is actually great on this device. But Google in the Google Suite is going to work much easier. So if you are a Google Suite user, it's going to be a much easier transition. And because I am, that made the switch a lot easier. The second thing that I learned is that switching apps is a pain, but it was a process that I actually enjoyed. Well, enjoy might be a stretch, but it's kind of like cleaning out your closet. You know, take all the clothes out and then kind of put the clothes back in that you need. And you realize, you know what? I got a lot of stuff in that closet that I probably should have gotten rid of a long time ago. And that was the way with apps. I had so many apps downloaded that I hadn't used in probably years, but I was like, oh, I don't want to delete it because what if I need it all of a sudden? Well, you know what? I cleaned out the closet. I picked out the apps I needed. All the apps are there that I need and that I use. I actually found a few new ones along the way that I really like. And so, you know, actually one of the things I learned is I always use Things for my kind of to-do list within the iPhone, because I never really found a good to-do list. And then I actually found the tasks list within the Android device is way better. And so I improved a few areas. And so that's been great. Now, It was a bit of a pain, and it's a, you know, like if you were to even delete all your apps and you stay an iPhone user, I think it's a good exercise, But it's still not fun. Start all over and get all the passwords transitioned. The third thing that I learned that was really interesting is it's nice to separate work and personal. And the way that the Android is set up, at least the Google Pixel is set up, is it's really easy to make the transition from personal and work. And you can kind of separate the two with two different experiences within your phone experience. And so I love that separation, and maybe there's a way to do it on iPhone. I just never had it. I'd always kept it all integrated. And if you want to integrate it all on the Android, you can do that, but you have the flexibility to separate the two and really customize in a unique way. So I love the separation between the two, and I've learned how that works within the Android experience, and I'm a fan. All right, the biggest thing that I already mentioned, but I think that it's probably the biggest reason to make the switch is it's cheaper. This is a $300 device, and I feel like I actually am having a better experience than the $1,000 iPhone, and the iPhone that I transitioned from was iPhone 10. And so switching from the iPhone 10 to this phone, I think it's a better experience. I think the camera is better. I think the operating system seems to move faster. And maybe it's because it's a new phone and I have less on there. So we'll see in time. But overall, I'd say the experience is better, and for about $700 cheaper, I'll take that. And I'll take that savings. And now I feel like, you know what, I could actually spend a little bit more on my next Android device now that I feel comfortable with it and get an even better device for less money. So I'm excited about the cost savings long term. And I feel like, you know what, I can get a new phone every year rather than waiting every 2 to 3 years like I was doing with the iPhone, because of the significance of the cost. All right, let's talk about iMessage. I hear so many people tell me, I don't wanna switch from iPhone because I don't wanna lose the blue messages, the iMessages. And even now I get text messages from people that are irritated that they gotta see my text messages in green. You know what? Get over it. iMessage is such a scam from my perspective. I don't get it. I don't understand the significant value of iMessage and why you want to just be able to communicate with other iPhone users in that way. And people will say, well, I can do it on my computer or my phone. You know what? You can use messages, messages for web is what it's called on the Android. So messages for web basically is iMessage within a browser. And I think everything on our computer should be able to work within a browser, by the way. And so you use messages for web and you can see all of your text messages from iPhone users and from Android users all in one place. It's a better experience. It doesn't, you know, switch between the two and just, you know, let you only communicate with your iPhone users. It lets you do it all within that platform. So on my computer, I have that browser tab open all the time so I can text message with people that are on all devices, not just Apple devices. So I think I actually stepped up away from iMessages, didn't take a step back. That's my two cents. Now, one thing that I do feel like I lost was FaceTime. FaceTime was so easy to use. It worked so well in just being able to go face to face with somebody on a mobile device to a mobile device. And so I'll concede when it comes to the video conferencing side, Google has their version. I don't get it. I don't know that many Android users, to be honest. And so I have not even used it. What I have found myself using is using Messenger video more and more, and that seems to work well when it comes to other users and people, you know, have Messenger on their apps. And so I've been able to do video calls easily through Messenger, do a few Zoom calls through it. That works fine, but it isn't as easy as FaceTime was right there within the phone platform. So I'll concede losing FaceTime is a loss. I wish there was a platform just like, you know, Messenger or messages for web with text messages that would just make video conferencing easy across all devices. It's not there. So I miss FaceTime. Okay. A few other things that I've had to adjust to is the gestures, things that I always just did for so long, 10 years on the iPhone, I'm having to get used to and what the different buttons do and what the different functions are. And so I'm having to get used to the gestures. Now, one of the things I love is the flexibility. I love when I got my phone, I watched a bunch of YouTube videos and I'm actually able to tell my phone, this button should do this and this should do this and this swipe. But even though I decided how I want it to be set up and I have way more flexibility, it still takes some getting used to. And so I'm still adjusting and adapting to all the flexibility. And so that's gonna continue to take some time. And that's a bit of a pain, I'll admit that. But I believe that 6 months down the road, a year down the road, I'm going to complain about, remember when I had no flexibility and I just had, and now I can change this and I'm used to all of these things. I think that the flexibility is worth it. The gestures, a little bit of a challenge making the change. So if you make the change to an Android, it's going to take you some time to get used to the buttons and the swipes. And the truth is a lot of the Android devices are different. And so it might change device to device. The good news is you're able to really customize it. And so whatever you'd like, you're probably able to customize your next Android device to your personal preferences there. And then the other thing that I think is important, and people, you know, this is, you know, our smartphones are our primary cameras. And so I do a lot of videos. I do a lot of social media. I have kids. I want to take good photos of them. I love this Pixel camera. For a $300 smartphone, this camera is just as good as my iPhone 10. And so I really like the camera on here. Some of the other Android devices have a tremendous camera. Now, the iPhone has a great camera too. So I'm not going to say it's a ton better, but I would say that it is just as good, if not a little better. I love some of the focus, what it does. Sometimes it's a little funny in the way it kind of like pauses at the end of videos. I don't know if it's the Pixel in particular or if it's just how it takes photos. So I feel like the photos are maybe a little crisper, but sometimes they, because of the little movement or the time it takes, or maybe it's just me getting used to it, but they'll blur a little bit when I move it and I don't hold it as still. I'm still getting used to it, but I like the camera, and I think as I get used to the camera and how to best use it, it's going to be just as good. I'm not going to skip a beat when it comes to the camera. So overall, I'm loving the Switch. I don't think I'm going to be going back to an iPhone anytime soon. I highly encourage you considering taking the Switch, especially if you are a Google user with Gmail and Google Calendar and Google Drive. I think you'll be very happy about the Switch, and then you'll be very happy about the money saved. But you know what? If you like iPhone, enjoy your iPhone. If you like spending a lot of money, enjoy spending a lot of money. If you like saving money, if you like flexibility, if you like Google products, an Android device is a win. And I think now is a great time to make the leap. The one thing I will you know, say is iPhone has just released their new iPhone that is more cost effective. And had that have come out 3 months sooner, I might not have made the leap and I might have stayed on the iPhone world. But you know what? I made the Switch. I've made the adjustment. And for the foreseeable future, you'll see an Android device in my hand. Thanks so much for watching. I'd love to hear your thoughts. I'd love to hear any other tips you might have for those that are switching from iPhone to Android, because I think there's going to be more and more of us that come behind and begin to make the leap into the customized, flexible, affordable Android world. We'll talk to you on the next episode.